I'm here with one of the best young trainers in the business of boxing, Brandon Krause, who now is a trainer of a champion, Mia St. John. You and her went up to Fresno Packed House. She beat Christy Martin, considered a legend in the sport of boxing. Brandon, how does it feel, first of all, to be now a trainer of a champion, a WBC champion, not just like, you know...
It's great. I think it's great. My peers are giving me a lot of respect. I think I've earned a little bit of respect, something to go on my resume. I realize it's just the first step in getting some of the fighters I've been with since square one those same green belts. But now I have that much more experience, that much more knowledge, that much more know-how, and it was an honor to be involved in that situation.
What did Mia tell you after the fight? Because you guys did it. You had a good game plan. You stuck to it. And she beat Christy Martin. She had her revenge. And did she say anything to you?
She did. She gave me a lot of credit and a lot of love. And I just reciprocated it right back at her. And let her know that she's the one that went out there and fought the fight of her life. She's the one out there that was up there fighting. All I had to do was yell from the corner. She's the one that had to go out there and fight for 10 rounds. So all respect goes to Mia the Knockout St. John.
The fans were behind her. They were screaming for her. Tell me about that. Like, being in the corner, do you ever think, like, wow, this is surreal? Like, thousands of fans.
It was super exciting, you know. I've only ever been involved in... You know, four rounders.
But you've been to big fights, though.
Yeah, but you know, we were always in the supporting role, in the walkout role, or the opener, and to be a part of the main event, to fight for the WBC title. I mean, it was great. It's everything that my career as a coach is designed to bring, and I cockily want to say that it's the first of many.
And did you try on the belt?
You know I did. I have a couple pictures.
How cool is that?
It's cool.
How come there's no posters here on the wall?
You gotta give me some time.
What do you mean? The fight was a week ago. Exactly.
Less than a week.
Tomorrow was a week.
I know.
I was expecting to walk in here and see Mia St. John and you in the corner holding a belt up.
I'm working on it. I need to get more crack. Unfortunately, we had amateur fights the very next day. I mean, I had to jet back and be back in L.A. I didn't even get a chance to stay up there after the fight. And we were fighting two other times later in that week, and never gonna lose sight of what my number one priorities are, and that's getting a Furkan Rasky, Jesse Martinez, and Brian Rangel WBC belts to match Mia's.
What does it mean for the gym, for Outlaws, to you as a trainer, to win a world title with a fighter, A, and B, for the other people in this gym, like as motivation? Like, I'm sure everybody here was celebrating.
Everybody was stoked. I think it brought a lot of energy, a lot of positive energy. But yeah, there's nothing like winning. There's nothing like winning. There's nothing like being on a big stage and testing yourself and proving yourself. And I think everybody was really stoked. And I just keep that ball rolling and see that, hey, you know, the things that we do that make champions are the same things that my young men and women are doing, my young fighters are doing. And that if they just... trust training, and they just trust that they're going to improve, that they absolutely will.
Did you study a lot of tape of Christy Martin before the fight, and how did you come up with the game plan for Mia?
I studied every fight I could see for months and months and months, watching everything, watching their original fight to death, coming up with plan A, B, C, D, E, and F, had every contingency in the world. The only thing that I didn't plan on was it going so smoothly. I mean, it went how I thought it was gonna go, so surprisingly. I was so expecting some sort of monkey wrench, some sort of catastrophe, and it just never happened. It just went down the way that we planned, and it was awesome.
Women boxing was one of the biggest surprises in the Olympics. First year they had it was a huge success. The Irish fans packed the house for Katie Taylor. The American fans, since I came back here in America, everybody's talking to me about Clarissa Shields. They're not talking about the men boxers so much. But listen, everybody loves success, has a lot of relatives, and everybody's... So
correct.
Now that you won a championship with me, are you having more women fighters, girl fighters come in here?
I know. My first national champion was a female, Christina Swanson, and I guess my first world champion's a female, Mia St. John. So am I the trainer of the females now? What I tell female fighters that come to me is that I'm going to give you respect of a fighter. I'm going to treat you like a fighter. I'm going to give you expectations. I'm going to set up goals for you. You're going to have to come and produce for me. There's going to be things expected of you. I'm not going to coddle you. I'm not going to baby you. I'm not going to treat you any different because of your sex. And most of them really respect that, and I think thrive in that type of situation.
There you have it. So maybe 2016, we'll see you in the Olympics with the women's team. USA Boxing.
If not the men.
There you have it. Stay tuned for more. Brandon Krause, BeIsLuderPoint.com. I'm Eli Sekbak reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Sekbak.